It can be hard to understand what we've never seen, and that is the essence of faith, believing without seeing. In the Quran, there is a verse that captures the spirit of understanding. And Maha Ayesh recites it regularly. Uplift my heart for me, make my task easy, remove the impediment from my tongue so people may understand my speech. Ayesh has quite the story to tell.
My religion is a catalyst to who I am today. It has created an identity of compassion and kindness and respect and allowed me to be who I am, and that's the authentic self that I am.
The 31-year-old is the eldest daughter of five, born to Palestinian immigrants who came to the United States in the early 1980s. Ayesh Ayesh, starting a trucking business in Elgin, pursuing the American dream for his children.
He's such a hard worker, and he was so passionate about providing us a foundation to be successful. And him and my mother never had that opportunity.
We are proud of my daughter. She is a strong girl since she born.
From a young age, Maha was a star student, and her parents told her to shoot for the moon.
Follow her dream.
That dream began at the Islamic Foundation School in Villa Park. Ayesh graduated from Willowbrook High School, Elmhurst College, and Adler University, where she earned a master's degree in forensic psychology.
They built an area for us to seek an education, to seek a profession.
When she entered the workforce, her background was an asset. She served as a translator for Iraqi refugees and then as a juvenile justice liaison for the Kane County Sheriff's Department. It was there her dream became clear. But would her background also be a barrier?
I knew there was something I was looking for. I was exploring, I was searching, and I knew it was going to be different, and it required me to be uncomfortable.
Bravo 5, Signal 9. 28 of B-Boy D. David, 13535.
Oh, a typical day is never the same.
Right now, he just turned to the right lane without using his signal.
In October 2020, Ayesh joined the Bartlett Police Department, where she works on patrol.
Hello, sir. The reason I stopped you is you forgot to use your signal turning left.
It's an unspoken fear. I used to tell myself, me be a police officer, a woman that wears a hijab, probably not.
It's something she had never seen before, but a conversation with a former mentor inspired her.
She said, Maha, then break that. Then break that stereotype, break that image that maybe just because they haven't seen it before, that you can't be the one to begin.
I am the first one. And that's where I was able to see that, oh my God, there are barriers. Absolutely. But I found the voice and I found the story to push past that.
Ayesh is now the first Muslim female police officer in Illinois to wear the hijab or headscarf on duty. The department having to update its standards of appearance to include the hijab as part of her uniform. During the Illinois State Police Training Academy, she also pushed to be allowed to wear sleeves under her polo t-shirt.
I could do everything. It just required some sort of modesty and accommodation.
She does an excellent job of being able to break down barriers. She's just a positive role model, especially for women and young children. And she just, because of her background and just how personable she is, she has this uncanny ability just to connect with our community.
There have been some scary moments.
What led to a domestic battery event then led to me and my sergeant getting injured in the process.
And facing negative stereotypes.
Yes, I was a target of certain, phrases in the community or individuals that might be passing by of anger and emotion. I'm not gonna avoid my dream because it's gonna be hard.
With those moments of challenge, she has found time to connect.
You made that boy's day, yeah. which is so incredible.
And that's what's so fulfilling about this job.
Surprising a boy who wants to become a police officer on his birthday and stopping by a neighborhood lemonade stand.
She is definitely a role model, not only in the community, but here in the police department. Our logo is to serve with care and protect with confidence. And that's what Officer Ayesh exemplifies.
back at the Ayesh home in Lombard during this holy month of Ramadan. It's time to break fast and give thanks for their many blessings.
I did it for him.
Ayesh's father, who always wanted to be a police officer, seeing his dream play out through his daughter.
She's doing her job, she's doing her duty, she's doing her religion, she follow her religion closely.
We believe in Maha.
It's very important to keep her scarf on all the time, and we all make sure she's in the safe field and around the safe people.
She's keeping the peace while keeping her faith.
You can break barriers, you can achieve the goals that your faith has set out for you, you can achieve your personal and your professional goals, and there's no need to compromise one or the other.
Stripping away stereotypes, hoping her story will help us all understand what we've never seen a little better.
I didn't have to change who I was and who I am.
Why has it taken this long? And I don't really have an answer for that, but I'm glad that I had the courage to take that step forward, and hopefully an opportunity for women to see that.
And the opportunity gave me a voice, and the voice gave me a story, and here I am.
Maha Ayesh frequently serves as a mentor and public speaker for young Muslim girls at the Islamic Foundation in Villa Park, encouraging them to dream big and not let anything hold them back from achieving their goals. Dana Rebick, WGN News.